I'm Ilian St. Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to talk about MeshCentral's Agent Ping and Browser Pong. Okay, so that introduction was a little bit goofy, but the topic is quite serious. When you run a MeshCentral instance, you may encounter situations where agents or browser will disconnect when a connection is idle for a certain amount of time. And this happens for various reasons. And in this video, I want to talk about what you can do to solve the problem. So let's take a look at that. First of all, I want to switch to just a few slides and to mention that you have your MeshCentral instance. It's on the left here. And you have browsers and you have mesh agents, and you can have MeshCentral Assistant, MeshCentral Router, and, you know, various pieces of software. They go and they open WebSocket connections very often to MeshCentral. And MeshCentral is a real-time server, so you keep those WebSocket connections and you send data back and forth in real time as you know, events happen and as things happen. So both the agent and the browser have a need to make long-standing connections to the MeshCentral server. So even if a browser is not doing anything, it still has a connection active to MeshCentral so that if a computer changes or comes online or so on, the website is updated in real time. Same for the agent. The agent has to keep a connection open in case an administrator wants to do a remote desktop session or a port redirection or something like that. Okay, so as agents and browsers on the right on this slide connect to MeshCentral, there's a whole bunch of various infrastructure that can get in the way, or that is in the way. And so you have, you know, home network with NAT routers, network address translation. You can have corporate networks with HTTP proxies. You can have firewalls. You can have a firewall on the remote side or on your side. You can have a reverse proxy like Nginx or Apache or so on your side. And so the connection, this WebSocket connection, will weave through various infrastructure, you know, components before it reaches MeshCentral. And one of the components here could decide that if the connection is idle for more than a few minutes, to drop it. So it could be a policy that is implemented by a firewall, by a reverse proxy, by an HTTP proxy on the remote side, or some kind of router on the remote side. And so what happens is that you'll see a computer connect, and maybe an agent connect on the website, and it will stay there for a while, and it will drop off and connect again, and drop off and connect again. And this should be very cyclical and very periodic. So maybe every 3 minutes, you'll see the agent just drop and come back. And it will come back, you know, quickly. It can come back within a second or two, but still it drops off and keeps coming back like that. And so that's a really good sign that you have one of these components on the path between the agent and MeshCentral that is terminating idle connections. Okay, now, if you notice this, the first thing to do is to see if it's any of the entities in your control that does that. If it is, you should really change the policy to increase the timeout. Or to eliminate that timeout, so that a connection that is idle, a valid WebSocket connection that is idle for half an hour or more, should still remain, and if possible, indefinite, so that you have a mesh agent, they're connected for months on end, maybe, and so you want to never drop that connection. So the first thing you do is you go and check your policy in your Nginx configuration, in your load balancer, in your firewall, and if you have control over some HTTP proxies on your network, take a look at those policies. So that's the ideal. Now, sometimes you can't control that. You know, you don't own these infrastructure pieces. And so you can take a stopwatch, and you can take a look to see how long it takes before one connection arrives and it drops and then arrives again. So, you know, how long can a connection stay idle before the infrastructure drops it? And so you can measure that. And then what you can do is configure MeshCentral to artificially create traffic, dummy traffic, just for the purpose of keeping that connection alive. And so what we're going to talk about is the ping and the Pong setting in MeshCentral. And so a ping is some artificial, in our case, not the, there's a ping in the ICMP protocol, but like the ping command. But we're not going to talk about that ping. We're talking about a ping inside the WebSocket of between MeshCentral and the agent. So that's that type of ping. And so what you do is you send some data over to the agent, and then the agent will see that data and send back a Pong command. And what you want to do is have the ping and the Pong as small of a command as you can, so that you know you don't have to send very large ping command, because all you're wanting to do is keep the connection alive. And also you want to try to avoid sending ping commands if you're already using the channel for something. So if you're transferring data, if you're doing a remote desktop session, there's no really good purpose for sending pings and pongs because the connection is not idle. But if the connection has been idle for a certain amount of time, what you want to do is send a ping packet, and you can have the agent respond with a Pong response. Now, the thing is, a lot of these infrastructure components don't care what direction the traffic is. As long as there's data going in one of the two directions, then that's good enough to mark the connection as a connection that's active, and therefore you know, it won't get closed. So another option is to just send the Pong. You configure MeshCentral to say after 30 seconds or after a few minutes of idle time, send a Pong to the agent or the browser. And when the agent or the browser receive a Pong command, they will not reply back. So that's kind of the rule. If you get a ping, you reply with a Pong. If you get a Pong, you just you ignore it. And so the reason why you want to do this is that it's more efficient. You get less traffic on your network. Okay, and we're all about, especially if you're going to scale MeshCentral to thousands, hundreds of thousands of nodes, you're really about efficiency. You want to try to cut this traffic. The other thing to note is that if you're running on AWS, the inbound traffic costs nothing, but the outbound traffic costs money. So you really want to cut the amount of outbound traffic you're doing to the absolute minimum. Okay, so obviously you only do this if you really have to, but the commands are in the settings section of MeshCentral, and they are browser ping, browser Pong, agent ping, or agent Pong, and then you put a value in seconds, and that will be the number of seconds of the connection being idle before a ping or Pong is sent. Now, it doesn't make any sense to have both the ping and the Pong. Quite often on GitHub, I see this, people send me their sample config.json, and I see both an agent ping and an agent Pong. This has really, really no value, because the Pong will just send, you know, this, and then the ping will send this, and you'll get an answer back. So you have you're basically doing three packets, when probably you only need one. You only needed this one. So what you do is I suggest always starting with just the Pong. So you want to have just the agent Pong and probably just the browser Pong. And that's all you're probably gonna need. And then this, the time in seconds, you put the highest value you can. So, you know, 120 is 2 minutes. And so if you see that it's still disconnecting, then you drop that, you know, to what you want. You probably want to be 5 seconds below whatever policy the drop will be at. And so that's a good thing. There is one thing to note. You probably want to be around 5 seconds because you want the TCP stack, if it has to retry, that it has time to do it before the tunnel is considered idle. So just put it a few seconds before the final timeout. And so if your packet gets lost, the TCP stack will retry it before the connection closes. So that's something to consider. Okay, so I'm just going to try this out on my test server. So I have my developer server right here. Of course, there we go. I am going to log into it. And of course, I don't need to use a username and password. I don't have a login screen, and that's because I put --/ user admin here, so that it just logs me in as administrator all the time, which is great if you're a developer or a tester. Don't have to deal with the login screen. Of course, don't do that on production. That would be a bad idea. Okay, so let's take a look at my config.json. Right now, I am going to clean that up. I'm going to put just agent Pong 5. So that's what I'm going to do, agent Pong 5. I'm going to run the MeshCentral server. Now, 5 is a very low number here, but I just want to pop up Wireshark and show you what this looks like. So I have this agent and this agent here. They're every 5 seconds, they're being sent a Pong message by the server. So I'm going to open up Wireshark. And I am going to, let's see here, I'm going to connect on Ethernet. Now I have a lot of traffic, but lucky for me, I pre-built a filter. And all this filter does is says any traffic between this, my MeshCentral server and this specific agent, AMT15, every time you see that traffic, then show it on the screen and ignore the rest. And what you'll notice, now you'll notice that every 5 seconds, so I see 6, 11, 16, 21, 26, every 5 seconds you get the agent receiving a Pong packet, and then so that's the application data, and then the TCP stack acts that Pong packet. So that happens at a lower level. The ACK here does not have any data in it. Okay. And by the way, it says TLS 1.2, but that's just because I started it before. So I'm going to actually restart it here. Don't save. And I'm going to restart the server. So what I want to do is have Wireshark start capturing the traffic at the beginning of the TLS session. And so you see here it's TLS 1.3. So now what happens is that it's going to stabilize after a little bit here. But, and then the Pongs will start, and then you'll see TLS 1.3. But I just wanted to point out that that we always use TLS 1.3 with MeshCentral between the agent and with the browser. We accept 1.2 and 1.3. We do not accept by default on the main HTTP port, HTTPS port 443, we do not accept port, anything below TLS 1.2 for security reasons. So TLS 1.1.1.0, those are not considered secure anymore. Okay, so that's an agent Pong at 5 seconds, and you can clearly see here TLS 1.3, and you can clearly see the Pong. Now I'm going to go back into config, and this time I'm going to switch it to ping. Ping every 5 seconds. And I just want to show you, I want to show you what it looks like when you ping every 5 seconds. And I'm going to reset the trace here. There it goes. I didn't catch it from the beginning. Okay, now 1.3, good. So now it's going to stabilize, and then we're going to start seeing the traffic. And here what we're going to see is MeshCentral sending to the agent application data inside the TLS session. This is the ping packet. And then there's going to be a response from the agent back to MeshCentral. This is the Pong. And of course, the Pong has to be acknowledged with a TCP ACK. So here, you know, it sends this data, the ping. The Pong actually includes the acknowledgement that it received the ping at the TCP layer. And then, of course, the Pong has to be acknowledged by the server. So now I'm doing two round trips when I'm using a ping. So just be aware, if you use ping here, you're doing actually 1.5 round trips. But if you're doing a Pong, P-O-N-G, then you're doing only one round trip for packets. And as far as anything above the TLS layer, you're just doing a single one way. So hopefully that was useful. Basically, the key idea here, what I want to illustrate is use ping and Pong only when you need it. Change your infrastructure settings if you can to allow idle, long-running WebSocket connections. And then if you have to use, you know, dummy traffic to keep the connection alive, try to use Pong if possible. And then if that doesn't work, use ping. Okay, hopefully that was useful. Thank you very much.